Hey guys, I never really know how to do voiceover videos, but welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a soft glam makeup look featuring the Zambian beauty.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you so much for allowing me to do this makeup look with you. I first start off by prepping her face with a NYX setting spray. I'll list everything I use in the description box. I don't want her head to use the Benefit Goof Proof. Is it Goof Proof? Brow pencil to align her natural eyebrow shape. I like to do like really small strokes because I like eyebrows to look as natural as possible. I then went ahead to clean her eyebrows up with concealer, and we're using the MAC concealer palette. I think I used the I don't think they were the lightest shade, but they were close to her skin tone, just like a shade or two lighter than her actual skin color. I like to do that for underneath the brows. And when it comes to the top part of the brow, I like to use a concealer that is the same shade as her skin tone. What I've noticed is that it makes the eyebrows look a lot more natural and clean. So what I'm doing here is just outlining it. As you can see, I'm taking my time to do so. And I'm really like exaggerating the line I'm creating with the concealer. This gives me more precision in how far my eyebrows will reach. So that's basically what I'm doing. So I went ahead to blend out the concealer that's underneath the eyebrows, and I'm not drawing the concealer all the way down to her eyelid because I will be priming her eyes with this Too Faced 24 hour eye primer. And I'm using a brush to blend that out. The reason why I like to use primer and not concealer is because primer really like allows eyeshadow colors to pop out. Speaking of eyeshadow colors, we're using the Jackie Aina palette. Yes, Jackie. But anyways, seriously guys, I used the color Ginger and Edges in her crease, and I'm actually using them as transition colors. At first I applied Ginger because I felt like it was more on the brownish side compared to Edges. Edges is more, has this more burnt orange kind of feel. So that's basically what I did. Then I went ahead to apply credits in order to like give her a soft smoky eye kind of look. Honestly didn't know what I was doing, guys. I just like wasn't sure of what colors I wanted to use. I didn't know if I wanted to go for a smoky eye, but I just like, you know what, let me just go for a soft look. So after applying credits, I went ahead to apply Lituation on her eyelid, and I really love the color, but my only issue was that it wasn't coming out the way I'd hoped it would. I am speaking rubbish English, but anyways, I went ahead to use Lituation, and when it didn't come out, I then decided to put Wiggly's on it. So basically that's the color you guys are seeing me apply as of right now. And yeah, so when I applied Wiggly's, I then went back in with the color Ginger and blended everything out. Now I'm using my Nip and Fab Dragon Blood Serum to prep her face. And while it dries down, I'm just going ahead to use the Juvia's Place eyeliner. This eyeliner is like the darkest eyeliner I've ever used in my entire life. I don't even know why I've been sleeping on it because I've had it for a while. So anyways, off camera, I went ahead to apply the Huda Beauty eyelashes, and I think it was Samantha. Yeah, I used that. So while I was waiting for eyelashes to dry, I went ahead to apply concealer. Now here's my trick. Yeah, let me just explain this. When it comes to her scars, I decided to use concealer that matched her skin tone. It wasn't my idea to like cover up all her scars because I was still going to apply a foundation anyway, but then I decided to use that concealer and an orange correcting color under her eyes and on her forehead. So then I blended it out with my beauty sponge and I used my stippling brush to like even everything out. So yeah. Now we're applying the foundation. She brought her foundation along, which was the Lancome Tandy Doll in the shade 11. But because I felt like it was a tiny bit too light, I decided to go and add Too Faced Cocoa. Too Faced Bond This Way in the shade Cocoa. Yeah, that was the color. And I blended it out. As you can see, I didn't want to use too much foundation because I don't like cakey foundation. I don't like my foundation to be heavy. I want it to look like skin. So that's basically what I did. And I then went ahead and blended it out with a flat foundation brush. And now I'm using a stippling brush to like give my foundation a more airbrushed effect. I'm taking my time with this. And now I am going to highlight and contour. I used the Too Faced concealer in the shade, I think that was Chestnut. Yeah, in the shade Chestnut. And then I went ahead with my Sleek Contour Kit and applied the second to the lightest shade, like in the inner corner of her eye. So that is just to give it a more like highlighted effect. So now I'm applying her contour. I used the Sleek Contour Kit and the Makeup Revolution foundation in stick foundation in F17. And then now I'm reverse contouring with the Too Faced concealer. Now, as you guys can tell, I'm going to blend this out and explain what I did. When I'm doing reverse contour, I don't like my reverse contour to look like the contour that's under my eyes. So I like to use a shade that is maybe, let's say, two shades lighter than my actual skin tone, which is exactly what I did with her. And for the concealer underneath the eye, it has to be like maybe 3 to 4 shades lighter. That's basically how I like to highlight and contour. So I always blend my contour out first before blending out my highlights. That's because I will allow the highlight to, allow the concealer to dry down a bit so it doesn't move around. And then I just decided that her contour wasn't deep enough, so I added the darkest shade of the MAC concealer palette in there to kind of like, you know, create a more in-depth effect. And then I used the Sasha Buttercup powder to set her concealer or set her highlights. As you can see, I'm pressing it in. Mass is not doing no baking tints anymore. We don't bake, so we just like press it in and then wipe the residue or whatever is left of it off with powder. I use the L'Oreal powder. I can't remember what shade it is, but this helps to like, you know, counter any kind of flashbacks she might have when taking pictures. So yeah. Oh, now yes, I'm applying the CoverGirl Ebony Bronzer. This thing is not on sale anymore. I don't know what's doing this before, but it's okay, it's okay. Then I went ahead and used the, I think, Juvia's Place Sahara palette, and I used the two darkest shades. And let me tell you, this palette is pigmented. Don't go out and play yourself. Apply it gently, because if not, you're going to look like a clown. But anyways, yeah, I applied that, and then I used my Sleek powder contour kits. I used the highlight shade to, you know, give her that extra sum. So now I'm setting her face with that NYX setting spray, and then I used also used the Redo setting spray by Beauty Blender. And now I'm lining her lips with Colourpop Limbo, and I'm using Zuma, which is a pink shade in the middle, and applying NYX NYX butter gloss in the shade Eclair, actually, because it is in French. And then I added her Kiko Clair lip gloss and finished up the look by adding mascara, putting highlights underneath her eyebrows, just correcting anything I felt wasn't like, you know, perfect. So yeah, that's the finished look. Like I said, everything I use will be in the description box, you guys. Make sure you check that out. And yeah, thank you very much for sticking with me through this video. If you liked it, thumbs up, subscribe, and share. And I will see y'all in my next video. And by the way, this Jackiana palette is mad, isn't it? It's mad, 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 mad. I actually use the color Zam. Is it Zam? Yeah, Zam. Like I added Zam in the corner of her eye. So that's it. That's it, you guys. Thank you very much for tuning in. I'll see y'all soon.
I need to find somewhere to go today. I can't just waste the space.
Yeah.
It looks so good.
I love it.
Thank you.
Welcome. The palette's actually really nice. The Jackiana palette.
Oh my gosh.
Oh yeah.